KISW. DJ, we're all a fan of our next guest, and he has a new book called My Footprint, where he goes into detail about his battle with food addiction.
Let's say you put me in a room, and in the room is like the best beer in the world, the best wine in the world, the best pot in the world, the best cocaine in the world, and next to that is a two-day-old grocery store sheet cake. Okay, guess where I'm going. As a matter of fact, no exaggeration, half that cake could be covered in ants. I'd eat the other half.
Please welcome to the show, Jeff Garland.
Hey, good morning.
Oh, man.
Man, F ants.
Yeah. I'll tell you what.
That was the best look ever.
Classic. Jeff has got a book out called My Footprint, which is available everywhere, Amazon.com, Barnes & Noble, all the bookstores. And, Jeff, what is great about the book is that it's not so much, here's what to do. You're just going, here's what I was doing.
That's exactly right. I would never tell anyone what to do. That's kind of arrogant.
And I was reading the book going, okay, here's what's happening, here's what's happening. And, of course, I love Curb Your Enthusiasm. So when I was reading about, you know, what was going on behind the scenes during the Seinfeld reunion storyline in this year's Curb, and, you know, you basically called Jerry Seinfeld a sadist, I thought for sure, okay, something's happening, and Jeff's going to win out, and you didn't kind of win out, which is really different for a guy who's writing a book about trying to lose weight.
Yes, that's, well, I just wanted to write an honest experience about it.
You have an addiction that people don't really believe is an addiction.
Right, they don't. They think it's laziness. I'll tell you, let's even switch it around. It's an addiction. I'll tell you why it's an addiction. You look at alcohol. For an alcoholic, one drink's not enough, ever. You know, you can't just have one drink. For a drug addict, you know, you got to do all your blow, all your pot. You don't want to stop. Same with food addiction. One sandwich is not enough. One cupcake is not enough. And then I hear Tiger Woods and people call him a sex addict. Everybody likes having sex, and I don't think there's ever a line where people go, I've had enough today.
Right, right.
So I don't believe in sex addiction, but I think all the others are actual addictions.
Gosh, in the world of Hollywood, here you are, you're working on the show,
yeah,
and you know, you got Jerry Seinfeld. No, I mean,
hold on. Let me just say something.
All right,
here.
You can say, but only because I read it and I was pissed.
No, there's nothing to be pissed. I hope he's really a great guy, and he was having fun with me,
right?
Torturing me, and I found it amusing, to be honest with you. I wasn't upset by it at all. It made me laugh every time. But I did call. I called him sadistic. You know what I mean? Because he was.
Because if you want to tell the story, because you wrote the book, so I figured you could tell the story. But I mean,
well, you know, when he was doing the show, he and all the Seinfeld cast were very intrigued by my big salads for lunch and everything. And Jerry would say things to me like, "Hey, Garland, what are you gonna? If you could have anything you want for dinner tonight, what would it be?" And I thought for a second, I go, probably a cheeseburger and a chocolate milkshake. And he'd go, that's what I'm having.
Oh, yeah.
And then the joke of it was, I'd be at dinner with him, and then he'd order it and say, I told you I was having it, you know.
Oh,
so,
God, man.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
What a jerk.
No, it's not a jerk. It's funny. It's funny. It's in the book, because there's a fact that I discovered, that eating a cheeseburger is equivalent to like hundreds and hundreds of showers. You know what I mean? That much water.
Wow.
One cheeseburger.
And we don't, of course, we don't know this.
Yeah.
And the other thing.
What about like a small, like White Castle burger?
You're asking me like I'm an expert. And by the way.
There's 50 showers.
By the way, not only that, but by the way, man, I used to love my sliders.
Right?
Especially if I was constipated. If I was constipated, instead of taking X-Lax, I would run right to a White Castle and I'd be good.
It's like clockwork. No, he's not.
I did one time. I remember this now. I was playing in Cincinnati. This is a number of years ago.
Yeah.
And for the first time ever in my life, before a show, the guy who was driving me was very heavy. And he goes, I want to stop at White Castle. Do you mind? Do you want to get some sliders? And I go, I always want sliders. Let's go. Yeah. And I had about seven sliders, which is normal.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
I'm in the middle of my act, and I got to make diarrhea. Oh, you know what I mean? My stomach's ready to explode.
Yeah, yeah, we got that.
I've been doing this for 27 years. That's never happened before or since. And I actually had to say, I'll be right back.
What? In the middle of your set, you had to call time out?
Hold on a second here. When it's that bad, you got to go. And I had to run back, and I did a festival, and then I went back out.
That would have been sweet if you had a wireless mic, and you could just take the mic to the bathroom.
That would have been sweet for who?
For the crowd.
They would have loved that.
Sweet. What did you do while you went to the bathroom? Did you have like another comic go up there and just kind of kill time, or they just had to sit there and
I didn't
like,
worry about it. I didn't care.
You didn't have time to arrange this.
There were two reasons why I didn't care. Number one, it was Cincinnati. And number two, which I'll never go back to. And number two, I was in pain. Terrible pain. Did you hear about this lady that weighs like 1,000 pounds and she's going for the record?
I just read that,
To be the fattest person in the world?
Why?
Because it's America. That's why. And she has a website and people are sending her cookies.
She'll get a reality show.
I know, one that I won't watch, and I find it disgusting. That is, to me, why a lot of the world hates us, this lady.
You know, it's
by the way, Neil Diamond is, if I may, for one second. You know, I got engaged at a Neil Diamond concert because of the humor of it, as well as he's great, but he is goofy, you know, and you can laugh at him and enjoy him at the same time.
Right.
He gives you that. Not many people give you that. And he's at a point now where when he sings, he no longer has the vocal range, so he'll just suddenly scream, "We're coming to him today!" Song, song, blue, creeping in my window! You know, he just suddenly yells out.
Bah, bah, bah.
Yeah. That is so true.
Caroline!
There's
no range anymore.
We mentioned Jerry Seinfeld earlier. Yeah. How cool is it to have the entire cast to be a part of it?
Well, I'm a huge Seinfeld fan, so it was very exciting. As a fan, yeah.
That was, by the way, the best way to do a reunion. It was fantastic.
Well, they were thrilled with it because they felt the same thing. Like, if they ever did an actual reunion, which people have been clamoring for, you know, in the normal way, it would have been sucky.
What's so great about it is that you really got to see the brilliance of what Larry brought to that. You know, Jerry's very, very talented, but until Curb Your Enthusiasm came out, I didn't appreciate just how much Larry had to do with Seinfeld and the dynamic of how that show went.
Right, yeah. He had Larry, they were partners, you know, but Larry is a visionary, and you see how much Larry's like George. And to me, one of the highlights was when Larry played George.
Yeah.
That really killed me. Just killed me.
Oh, yeah. I felt when the both of them were at their restaurant and it was just going.
Who was going to do that? How much is your tip?
Yeah,
that was hysterical. Just brilliant.
But I have to say, one of the highlights of the season for me was you having sex with
Bam Bam with Catherine O'Hara's character.
Yeah, and she is basically nuts, this character.
Yeah.
And the Jeff character going, but hey, it was why wouldn't I do it? I mean, if the opportunity was there. And
that's exactly right. I say, if you love Curb, Larry David. You hate Curb, Larry David. Larry David, not me.
But
I'm just part of it. I'm along for the ride, and I'm lucky.
And look, I think it's great to give him credit where credit's due, but because a lot of it is improvisational,
My own dialogue is mine.
Yeah, that's... Mm-hmm. We talked to J.B. Smoove, and it's
easy,
great.
Though. It's easy, though, when the story is there. It's all easy. It's easy to improvise then, for me.
You know, Monique just came out and said that, you know what, they've got this, she's married to the dude she's married to, and she said, look, we both have an open marriage because I just noticed stuff happens.
Let's stop there. Who are we talking about?
Now, you know, I mean.
We're talking to Harry Legs Johnson?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Okay, somebody, do you ever want to have sex with Monique?
No.
Okay, my gut feeling is that she needed to offer that up to close the whole marriage thing.
Thank you.
She had to say to him, look, marry me, you don't have to have sex with me.
Right.
You can have sex with anyone else, we're just going to hang out. Even then, I'd probably say no.
I know, right?
But you know, by the way, she's so you watch her when she wins every award, she so believes the hype. There is no lucky factor in her, which disgusts me. You know, because we're all lucky to be doing what we're doing. You're lucky to have this gig.
You're right.
Great gig. You're lucky. Wouldn't you say the Academy Awards? Thank God the Academy is giving the award to talented people or people who deserve it, something along those lines. Really? Really? You're not lucky? Oh, my God.
I hadn't thought about it that way, but you're
hairy legs and huge. And she, they have an open marriage. Of course they do. That's how she keeps him. Imagine if she said, no, it's only hairy legs and fat for you, my friend. I'm sorry.
Yeah, if you want the legs shaved, you got to do it yourself. She can't reach that thing down there.
Oh, dear God, man. I didn't even go there.
Yeah.
DJ Shea Morning Experience on 99.9 KISW.